What's up, everybody? That go to red light right there. Y'all see the red light? All right. So follow the red light, because if you don't look at the red light, you're going to look stupid. Like, you're going to look, for real, I'm being serious, you're going to look stupid looking over there and talking. Like, I know I look stupid right now. Y'all looking on the television? Do I look stupid? Yeah, see, so.
Everybody just follow the red light.
Welcome to Hip Hop and Fashion. I'm your host today, Mr. Wayne, and I have my special guest celebrity co-host who's been on movies. She made a lot of money, and she came here to donate some of her time. Miss Tyra B, how are you today?
Wayne, how you doing? I'm back.
Yeah.
How you doing today?
I'm doing good, baby.
Doing good, baby. Okay, baby. Well, today on Hip Hop and Fashion, we have, as y'all can see, we have the kids, the can-do kids here. So I'm going to introduce the coach, one of the coaches, the founder, the president of the can-do kids, Coach Frank.
All right. Happy for me. Appreciate that. Hey, as you said, I'm the founder of Can Do Kids. My name is Frank Winfield, and I really don't like to be on TV.
Okay, well, with that being said, Coach Frank, we're going to introduce Eric Weary. He's also one of the coaches of Can Do Kids.
How you doing? Thanks for having me.
No problem. So tell us a little bit about the Can Do Kids Academy and what do you guys do?
Okay. The Can Do Kids Academy was founded 8 years ago through Coach Winfield, but it was uniquely designed to teach kids athletic skills and life skills through athletics.
Okay.
So that's what we, the athletic portion of it was more of a portal to get the kids into, to mentor them.
Okay.
And so for life skills, to teach them the life skills that they're gonna need when they become adults.
Okay.
So.
Why did you, I guess you kind of sort of answered the question of why did you guys start it, but what happened in your life that made you see a need or a desire to do the things that you're doing with the kids?
Yeah, you know, we spoke a little bit outside about that before we came in, but, you know, just coming up and living in New Orleans and going through some of the struggles that we go through on a daily basis, just with the peer pressure, with some of the violence and that what goes on, and we, it was a struggle, but I made it through, you know. God be the glory. Uh-huh. But I also, you know, I grew up in a neighborhood with my guy, Coach Frank, and he was very instrumental in my life to getting me to where I am today. So I just wanted to give back to him and also to the kids as well, because they are our future. So without us, you know, helping the
without
kids.
Them, right? And they're definitely our future.
Right.
And I want to challenge everybody to reach back and grab a kid and mentor them, because without the kids are our future. So get them off the streets. Give them something to do. Basketball, sports is a good way to get them off the streets. Summertime is coming up, and there's a lot of academies going on, a lot of camps going on. So we definitely want to get the kids into the camps. And just, you know, be a mentor and grab each kid. If we could save one kid at a time, it's good. Each one reach back and teach one.
Yeah. And the music stuff. I believe the children are the future. Tim said, Coach, Mr. President, why? I sense that this is a passion for you. Why?
Well, coming up, you know, like Coach Eric said, coming up, we went through some struggle, you know. We wasn't always on the right path. You know, we did some things that not too proud of, and we made some people homes pretty, you know, unbearable. I could imagine, you know, from some of the things we did. So, you know, once you have a change of mind and a change of heart, you know, God reached back, got me right, got my mind right. So I feel, you know, that I have to do it. And, man, these kids right here, man, you wouldn't believe it. These are some of the most special kids I've ever been around. Every one of them, you know, and he'll tell you, man, we've been through some real tough things, really tough that, you know, maybe another time we can discuss, but this right here for me is everything. Can Do Kids, what it means to me or to some of them is I've never seen a kid that can. That's
our motto.
Right. Yeah, how did you come up with the name Can Do Kids? How did that name come about?
Because, you know, coming up in broken homes or what have you, you always hear, you ain't gonna be nothing. You can't do this, you can't go there, you'll never be. And I feel totally different, totally opposite. So we flipped it. We said, you know what? we are can-do kids. We can-do parents. We can-do coaches. We can-do people.
Can-do.
And it starts right here with these kids right here.
Okay. And with that being said, we're going to give each kid a chance to introduce themselves, starting with you.
All right. There you go.
My name is Cannon Jefferson.
And how old are you?
I'm 10.
10. Okay.
My name is Terrence Crawford. I'm 11.
My name is Cameron Johnson. I am 11.
My name is Anthony Johnson. I'm 11.
My name is Jonathan Bax. I'm 11.
My name is Kaden Jones. I am 10.
My name is Christopher Locke. I'm 11.
My name is Chavez Johnson. I'm 11.
My name is William Lawton. I'm 11.
Okay.
William Lawton.
And my name is Jared Winfield. I'm assistant coach, and I help Coach Frank get these kids to the place they need to be as far as mentally, physically, and emotionally, and to make sure they do whatever they got to do to reach the top. And like.